But it is the fact of the matter. Nothing happened. An event is, by definition, anything that happens, but the ride was, as I said, uneventful. I suppose I breathed, as did General Killjoy, and the wheels rolled, and we may have shifted in our seats, but these hardly qualify as events, do they? Holy hell was unmistakably happening. This entire story has been one significant occurrence after another. But the ride back to the observation lounge was without incident. Stories are eventful, full of circumstances of importance and intrigue. But this is not at all an accurate reflection of life. Life, like this chapter, can be rather uneventful at times. Oftentimes you find yourself on the toilet or in a traffic jam or watching television commercials or countless other instances that get edited out when someone asks what you did with your day. Blip sometimes boasted of how little he did on some days. As he argued it, the aphorism that you can't get something for nothing is dubious at best and is probably a product of our culture's capitalist work ethic. Therefore, he said, he actively did nothing, especially when the money politics of the university aggravated him. He saw his behavior as subversive, akin to factory workers who deliberately slow down the pace of their work to reduce the owner's profits. Blip told me of a time last spring when he continued doing nothing, even when he was home from the university. All evening, he sat in an easy chair in his living room, no book, no television, nothing. Every time Sophia wandered in and asked him what he was doing, he replied, "Nothing," and immediately fell silent again. After the third or fourth time, Sophia finally insisted that he must be doing something, even thinking. But Blip persisted in asserting his inactivity.